Your comment, please, on the fact that the Trump administration will allow new offshore oil and gas drilling in most U.S. waters, opening access to more than 100 million acres.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, no. You can imagine what my reaction is to the Trump administration, you know, opening up offshore drilling and national parks and everywhere else. It's a total unabrogated outrage. You know, and the fact that the Democratic Party and the all of us in the country are even allowing that to happen, you know, standing back and saying, well, we have to preserve the prerogative of the president to make these kind of executive rulings, you know, because we've set up a whole system where we've delegated that kind of power to the president. You know, that I think this guy is so completely outrageous, Trump, that, you know, he's threatening to damage major institutional agreements that have been made to allow a president to have those kind of discretionary powers, you know, that it's worth revoking them, you know, from him. But the problem is, if you start revoking them from people who are just doing things that you disagree with, you know, even when people get in to do the kind of things that the executive ought to have some discretion to do, you're eliminating those abilities. So that's one of the reasons that Trump and his administration are so terribly dangerous. But it's not just the temporary period of this, however long it takes to get him impeached, if we can succeed in doing that. He's doing serious long-term damage to the stable institutions of the democracy that we have developed over the past 250 years. You know, that it's really a significant danger to the body politic of what's going on right now. But the bottom line, that one of the most egregious areas of violation on the part of the Trump administration is this issue with regard to global climate change in oil, in the petroleum drilling, of him not only opening up the offshore drilling and drilling in the national parks, he's now insisting upon opening up Indian reservations because he realizes the federal government has some authority even on Indian reservations, and they've now ordered the opening up of Indian reservations to oil drilling. So this is a total outrage, and I think that the Democratic Party is not doing enough to foreclose these types of rulings on his part. But it's totally outrageous, and I think we're in the process of contemplating, others need to do it too, is bringing an action against Trump, you know, to show that he is overriding years of administrative decisions that have been made pursuant to the due process under the Administrative Procedures Act, by just unilaterally stepping forward and doing this. You know, for example, his ordering of the pipeline to be completed, the North Dakota pipeline, Dakota Access. You know, there had already been a determination made by the Federal Department of Interior, the United States Justice Department, you know, and the president and others, that in fact that pipeline could not be lawfully completed without completing a full environmental impact statement. And Trump just came in and set that aside and ordered the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to issue the certificate of easement to allow them to complete the pipeline. It was a complete and clear violation of the Administrative Procedures Act, you know, which sets up, it's a whole federal statute in a regulatory system pursuant to which due process needs to be observed, you know. So it's an outrage, you know, the whole thing. And as people might have guessed, I would have thought.